I'm often asked, what is the best antenna? So there is no such thing as the best antenna. Every antenna does a different job. Even a crappy antenna will be doing something quite well. And we'll prove that to you. I'm using a piece of software here called MMANA. And if you've been following along the channel, you will gradually be getting to know how this works. So I'm just going to draw some random dipole. I'm going to do 40 meters, and it makes more of an impact to the discussion I'm trying to have. So 10.2 meters up there and minus 10.2 meters. Minus 10.2 meters there. So I'm just going to show you this is going north-south. Just a piece of wire at the moment. I'm going to put my feed point, my coax wire one, in the center of that, and we'll lift it off the ground about, well, it's 10 meters at the moment, 10 meters high, which is the equivalent of a 20 meter antenna, 14 megahertz, up at twice the height. All right, don't do the maths. This isn't going to make any bloody difference, but I'll make it out of wire. We'll start that. We'll get wrong band, 7.2, I think, ish. Let's have a look. It might be 7 plots SWR. Where's that resonant? It might be actually 7 dead. Yeah, it is about 7 dead. Whatever. I'll just put 7 there. And then we'll do a vertical, and I'll show you why they've both got completely different characteristics. All right? So there's our dipole at 10 metres. Now, for the average Joe with a bit of wire in his backyard, his back garden, that's going to be about right. By the way, if that was an inverted V with about 45 degree legs, that's going to be roughly omnidirectional. At the moment, there's a little bit more off the edges than there is north and south. But believe me, we do inverted V one day. But anyway, I'll just park that over here because we're going to fire another instance of this up. And this time I'm just going to, didn't want that. This time I'm just going to draw a vertical at, I don't know, 10.2 meters off the ground. We're going to feed it at the very bottom, wire one base. And there it is, sitting on the ground, the feed point's coming along here. This automatically knows we've got some 16, we'll give it 16 quarter wave radials, right? And you'll see why some of them, we are about to see not only the difference, but the benefits of either, okay? So we can save this as the far field plot. Save far field plot in vertical. We'll just call it a vertical. Far field plot. So when I go over here now, we can go tools compare. I can load my vertical. There it is. So this is how to compare the two. All right. Now we can give that a color if we want to. Make it blue, whatever. And we'll maximize this up a bit just so you can see it better. So you can see, I mean, there's nothing special about either of these antennas, but up to 20 degrees off the horizon, the vertical is marginally better. Right? We think it's marginally better. And certainly if you want more local working, you'll find the dipole is better. Can you see that on the right-hand side? Absolutely clear as mud. So we can do very specific things. What we could do is say, well, just show me at 20 degrees off the horizon what that one's doing, and show me at 20 degrees off the horizon what this one's doing, and then we can spin around here and it will tell us we're about, it says we're 1.1, it says it there in the middle, 1.1 dBi, and then this one is 1.1 dBi at 20 degrees. Now, if this was an inverted V, we would take some of this gain off here and it would put it there, because at the moment we're a bit low over there. Now, you will know that I run a vertical for all my antennas all the time. So I would be louder if elevation, let's say 45 degrees, which on the 80 meter band is probably, on average, 200-300 miles. I don't know. Let's have a look. So I'm zero, all right, compared to 5 dB eye there and about the same off the edges. In other words, we can see clear as mud that for daytime local work, right, your 40 meter dipole, rough fence height, doesn't matter, off an apple tree, is going to be doing a great job. And there it is. And that's the job it's doing. So vertical, if it's very close, if you've got a friend of yours 100 miles away, very often, I mean, what amazes me is sometimes that people hear me very well 50 miles away. So it's just something to do with propagation. But in the main, NVIS, near vertical incidence, skywave propagation, NVIS propagation, your low to the ground dipoles be better. But certainly for nighttime working 1480 vertical is fantastic because it's generally longer skip. And for 20 and up, your vertical for your transmit is going to be a bit better. I just want to interrupt this edit because, well, I'm right in the middle of the edit and realise that what I've missed is a couple of quite important things. Well, see, the only important thing I've really missed, I just didn't record, is what happens low down. Okay, so I'm just going to bring this dipole down to 10 metres. I've been playing with it. Because we've looked at what happens at higher levels, and I just happened to mention, I just realised in the edit, that for DX, you know, what's going to happen? Okay, anyway, let's just start measuring it. So if we go down to 5 degrees off the horizon, where the kind of real DX is, and just measure this at 175. So this is a 40-metre dipole at 10 metres height. Best gain we're getting here is 9.8. And what I can do is I can just force that to show us. So best gain, it was minus 18 there, and we are minus 9.9, minus 10. We're on the vertical at 5 degrees of horizon. We're at minus 4.7. So we are definitely always going to be at 10 metres height, right? At 10 metres height, which is a quarter of a wavelength, regardless of what frequency, quarter of a wavelength, we're going to be 5-ish dB always better than the dipole until we start going higher. So I'm going to now go to 20 metres. Let's just to prove it to you. Let's rescale this for 0.5. Just rescale it up to 20 metre band and have a look at it now. And you'll see what will happen. It'll get a bit better because we're proportionally higher off the deck. And if we come down to 5 degrees of horizon, now we'll see that at half a wavelength off the ground, we can now match our vertical. That says minus 4.1. This one says minus 4.7. You'd never know half a dB. I mean, let's just say a half a wavelength off the ground in two directions, you will be getting about the same as a vertical. If this is not a gain antenna, not like a hex beam or something like that, okay? So, enough of me waffling, let's get back to the edit and then wrap up the video. Okay, here we go. So what's better? Depends on the time of the day and depends on the frequency. That's the point. There is nothing, options, that's what's best. Options. If you haven't got options, then you've only got the one anyway. And what you'll find is when I never had any options, it's all I had, right? What's the difference in 5 dB anyway? About an S point, depending on the radio, all right? You can definitely hear 5, 6 dB. I mean, that's quite a lot. That's like coming down from 100 watts to 25. Oh, you're a bit quiet now, you know. But if I'm in the UK and I'm trying to get hold of a guy in Germany, I would have thought that 25 degree takeoff to Germany from here, all right, which is maybe, I don't know, 1,000 kilometres, 600 to 700 miles, then either would probably work fine, all right? The real question is, what antenna do I use for receive, all right? Now, if you're interested in that, we can do a dedicated video about it. Because I'm a great believer in receive antennas. I think receive options are more critical than transmit options. But maybe I'll be a bit odd. That's all from me for today. All right, trust I've given you some food for thought. Something to think about. All right, all the best now. Bye-bye.